Thank you very much, Dr. Brashi. I mean, it's a pleasure to be here in this e-convention. I mean, from London to the world and connecting so many places. And I mean, I've been, as you were introducing me, 2 decades in the energy industry, of course, building gas plants, also building lithium-ion batteries. So I've been heading one of the largest integrators in the world of batteries that has a second life battery agreement with Hyundai Motor Company. So it was Greensmith, Wärtsilä Group, and Hyundai Motor Company using the second life batteries. I mean, I was very thrilled to listen to Dr. Yerbayan and to Mr. Schilling about Mercedes-Benz and the second life batteries. I've been building a plant with lithium-ion batteries second life that I remember was like 10,000 cells of the 10,000 cars with very different treatment of every single cell. I really remember it was the heaven for engineers and hell for the business people in a way, in our view. So, but we see that energy storage is fundamental. It's really fundamental. All what we are discussing here is crucial to enable wind and solar integrated globally as much energy storage as possible. And definitely everybody, we all, I mean, me, households, industries, we all talk about lithium ion and about chemical, electrochemical batteries. But if you look at real numbers, or real numbers, 99% of the global megawatt hours installed today in 2020, they are pump hydro. They are really hydro plants. So, and the reason is scale. I mean, so the issue with lithium ion is that lithium ion is the best in speed, is the best in modularization, and we are all convinced that for a small scale, and we can discuss what is a small scale or what do we call a small, and short duration, we can also discuss what is short duration. I would say as long as you need to drive a car, I would say that's the short duration, I wouldn't say, because that's where the technology is being developed. Batteries do a fantastic job, but it's like decarbonizing the planet. Building gardens and building, putting a lot of beautiful flowers. It looks great, but I mean, you need to start thinking in trees and forests, and you need really gigawatt scale energy storage. And that's, I mean, we have a technology that is fully complementary with lithium ion batteries. So we bring the bulky, long duration, large scale energy storage. So, I mean, some of our engineers, they say it's a pump hydro in a box, in a way, or pump hydro in a suitcase. We travel to develop projects. So, and this is a cryogenic energy storage. So it's using liquefaction technology. So very well-known mechanical, thermomechanical technology from oil and gas industry. So we cool down a gas, but the gas we use is air. I mean, that's the key, that we store the energy in air that is liquefied. So we take the air that is in the environment, cool it down by compression and by temperature until it liquefies. Extremely standard process in the global industry to produce oxygen, to produce nitrogen. And as you know, nitrogen, oxygen, and argon are the main components of air. So we use those off-the-shelf components made by tiny companies like Siemens and General Electric and ABB and Atlas Copco. So our partners. We compress the air by temperature. So we're talking about minus 190, 196 Celsius degrees. So pretty much the same. You have a liquefaction or a gas terminal or LNG terminal. So you store your energy in a very energy dense medium that is liquefied air. So just to give a sense of ratio, proportion, 700 liters of air in the gaseous state, like what we are breathing, is less than 1 liter in liquefied. So it's 700 times compressed, and it's compressed by temperature. So you just put it inside of a standard tanks insulated, like the ones you can see in hospitals, you see in factories, tanks to store propane, butane, LNG, oxygen, nitrogen, but this air, which is, since majority of it is nitrogen, is very inert. So, and you can have megawatts, gigawatts, and the key thing there, as many hours as you need. And we're not talking about 1, 2, 3, 4 hours. We're talking about 8 hours, 10 hours, one day, 2 days. I mean, as much as you require. So when you need it back, you can store it for hours, for days, for weeks, for months, but when you need it back, you gasify again. So you gasify again, so warming it up, so it multiplies 700 times in volume, and it blows a steam turbine that is as rare and as unknown like the ones that are produced by Andritz, by Sumitomo, by Mitsubishi, by GE, by Baker Hughes, by Siemens again. So the same common suspect. So what we do is having an industrial this assemble of technologies that are very well known from the gaseous and power industries to put them together to store energy in large scale and long duration. So we don't look at projects up to 4 hours because lithium ion is there very, very good. So we look at projects 5 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours. I mean, there is not really too many larger because we're normally coupled with wind and solar. So, I mean, if you have 10 hours is normally a very good deployment. And we look at the standard pieces of equipment. So then we take equipment that is fully demonstrated for the last 50, 60 years in the oil and gas industry. So we're talking about the standards from 25 megawatts, 50 megawatts, 100 megawatts. So we don't look for this 1 megawatt or 10 megawatts. Now that's very tiny for us. So and when you were asking about where the markets are, I mean, you can imagine. I'm personally honored to be elected member of the board of directors in the USA Energy Storage Association. So I mean, US is, I would say, by far the largest market for us today because of the wind and solar penetration, but also due to the regulation. So, I mean, is any place that would love, would pay the services of a pump hydro, that's the place where we come because we do the same as a pump hydro. The thing is that we don't need 10 years to develop the project. We don't need a large amount of water. We don't need any distance between height to put the water and pump it up. And we don't have any, frankly, we don't have any environmental concerns. So all our, the most exotic component of our system or element is stainless steel. So everything talking about recyclable, et cetera. So it's all can be very local, all don't really, they're really infrastructure that is very thin. You would call it copy paste, like IKEA or like Lego. So we simplify to 50 megs, 100 megs, 5 hours, 10 hours, 15 hours. And we have 2 plants running in the UK and we are constructing one of 250 megawatt hour in the UK and one of 400 megawatt hour in the US. And I can say that this technology probably 5 years ago was already proven, was ready, but there was no market because there is no need for energy storage until the integration of renewables is disturbing everything in a positive way. So, but we are the ones who, I mean, I heard from Valeska about, and also from France at the beginning, talking about the Swiss Army capabilities of Swiss Army knife capabilities of storage. The storage doesn't generate, and that's the thing that the regulators and the politicians and the utilities need to understand. The storage is to solve all the problems that an intermittent and unreliable generation provides, but don't expect storage to generate because the regulation for the storage needs to be for storage.